Welcome back, folks. Dow's up 420, Nasdaq's up 230, S&Ps are up 46. Let's go to Jim in Denver, Colorado. Hey, Jim, what's going on?
Tommy and Tom, how are you guys?
Oh, it's Tim. Tim, what's happening, brother?
How you doing?
I'm doing great, man. Yourself?
Good.
Good.
Riding the wave.
Riding the wave. So,
but we're surviving.
That's good, man. That's good. So, are you digging your paws into this gush?
Yeah, should I move this thing out or keep riding it? What do you think?
Let's take a look.
I need an expert view on this.
Gush, folks, is the direction S&P oil and gas 2x leverage. Trading $35 right now. Inside of this baby, it's the oil and gas business in general.
Yeah, and it's kind of the export, towards the XOP, you know the XOP, so.
Yes, so let's take a look at this. I got to bring this, look at this thing. This thing got so destroyed, it looks like it hasn't even moved off the bottom. I mean, this is so weird, man. Look at this chart, folks, and it goes like from $1,600 down to $12. Let me see, I got to do this.
Well, they did a couple reverse splits.
Yeah, you know, no, I get that.
Yeah.
Boy, this is okay. So, well, you got another ABC up here. 1 second. So, that B point's 34. The A point, oh my God, is 27, 46. Let's call it 28, 34. $6 gets you. Well, I see what's happening here. So, you just finished up another ABC up to 36. What is the X? What is this trade off of, Tim?
XOP.
XOP.
Yep, which is a spider. Exploration.
Okay, I got it. Okay, cool. So this will give me a better understanding of what we have here. So the XOP.
It follows oil pretty good, but not. I mean, the oil could be up and it could be down depending on how the.
Sure, because these are the equities that have come off the bottom. Oh, okay. Now I got a much clearer picture. Yeah,
I mean, I'd like to keep riding it, but it's like, man.
When I look at the XOP, it'd be saying, "Go, move it, man." Yeah. This has come right into ICE, which is $50.84, and you can see the volume dying on the vine, man. Because the XOP can pull back to 45, 50 pretty easy. You know what I mean? That you can see from that point. So, you know, I mean, the way I do, now, what happens when you have something like this? What I do, Tim, and this is what you can do. I'd put a stop right. Really close to it today, right? Because what happens, folks, is this, is that it's wicked when you get a stock that's going up like this. So instead of just selling it, like it's at $35.75, right? You could say, hey, the heck with it. Put a stop at $35.25. Only give 50 cents and that's it. Do you see what I'm saying? And if it keeps riding more dollars up, great. You grab it and just keep bringing it up and then I'd move it by the end of the day. That's what I'd do.
Thanks, man. You guys hanging in there? You doing good?
Yeah. I mean, you know, it's not been bad down here. What did happen, unfortunately, yesterday is that in Florida, we had the highest death toll yesterday. They're saying we're past the peak, but I don't know how you get past the peak if we had the highest death toll yesterday. You know what I mean? So
I'm hearing that around here, too, kind of, and I'm like,
yeah.
I guess, you know, they know, I guess, but you guys be safe.
You too, man.
You too, man.
Okay, have a great one, man. Have a safe one. Oil, Tommy, right?
Yeah.
Whisper number. Let's see what we got.
From Gush to oil, man, we got the inventory numbers in 8 minutes. What are they looking for?
They're looking for the whisper number is, what, that's 15 million barrels.
15 million.
The whisper is 11.9.
The survey is 11.
Survey, 11.9.
So analysts at about 12 million. The whisper at about 15. Big numbers, man, for sure. Jumping back to, I was checking this out. So right now you got crude at $15.55. Huge volatility priced into these products, as you may expect, right? If you jump to the noon expiration, we do have a contract with 1550 just to price in what they're looking for.
Okay.
You're only 5 to 7 pennies above there, right? So your bullish one's going to be a little bit more expensive. You're looking at $44. The bearish one, $37. You're still talking about $81 to make a max profit of $150. if you only let one expire. Now, keep it in mind, though, that you could see some volatility and have both of these expire, as in trade out one, maybe trade out the other, but a lot of volatility priced in, man. When you got to, if you want to buy both sides of this market, you got to put up more than $80, which represents 80 cents of movement.
Ooh,
and keeping in mind,
that's crazy.
You only have $1.50. That's why I said, really, you better have, not you better, right? If I was going to trade these, I would be looking for volatility in both directions. I would look to take money off of the table on one side and maybe look for the other side to come in as well. Because if you're just looking for value on one side of this trade, that's a lot of premium, 80 cents that you would need of movement to break even. And then you only have 70 cents of potential profit above that 80 cents of movement, right?
Yes. Yeah. No, it's a monster number.
Yeah.
So I'm thinking I'm going to put in 18 million barrels here. I'm going to go over the whisper number.
Okay, perfect. Put it in.
Let's see.
Now, one other one I'm just going to bring up for interesting volatility. If you are bearish right now and you wanted some defined risk, I mean, this is a basically at the money put, right? You have 1550 being the ceiling.
Okay.
You have until 230 is going to be your time that you have until, and you're going to have to put up 65 cents. So you're selling it at 1485. Your losses are capped at 1550, and you have exposure all the way down to 1050. And man, it's pretty remarkable to say that it's actually possible you could get $10.50 by 2:30 in the afternoon. Normally you would never say that, right? In this environment, it actually is, man. Not to say it's going to happen. I found a little bit of a bid over yesterday for sure. But we'll see what happens when we get those inventory numbers at 10:30.
Pretty amazing, man.
Yeah.
And if we take a look at some of the higher volume equities out here today, and there's no doubt, folks, this S&P is moving. You got Advanced Micro, which is down a buck and a half. You got Carnival's up a buck and a half. Delta's up 2:30. You got Boeing up 5.27, Facebook's up $11. Let's go take Apple's up $9. Look at that move on Apple. Holy cow!
Yeah, I think Google putting a bid across some of those equities in terms of if people are on their phones, if people are relying on the cloud, if people are still, you know, I imagine that's correlating to some. Microsoft after the bell, they're getting a bid today as well.
Right.
Facebook maybe, you know, Facebook advertising, right? Just in line with Google, probably,
and
in terms of...
And that's after the bell today, too.
It is, yeah.
Yeah, so you get Facebook...
It's remarkable.
Off the lows at 137, you're at 193. So Facebook, this is pretty wild, man. Facebook is back to where we were in November.
Not bad, man.
No, it's... Well, look at this. It's actually, on a longer-term basis, yeah, it's in the same consolidation that it's been in, man. This is pretty amazing, man. There's no doubt. If we go take a look inside the NDX 100, because that now the NDX is trying to get to its highs of yesterday. Haven't made it yet, but it's right next to it. The leader out here today inside the NDX is United. Have no freaking idea why United is the leader.
It was the leader yesterday too, right? You know what's really funny? As you went to pull that up, I remembered you had United. I went to check out United before you even pulled that up, and I was like, whoa, United's up 11% again today. They just went from 25 to 31 over the last 2 days, man.
Pretty amazing.
Yeah.
Zero people on the plane. You see the pictures? One person on the plane, folks. It's pretty cool how that you get your own private plane. Stay right there. Tommy and I are going to come right back at those oil numbers.